Bohr and I had been writing together on nuclear physics. An idea about particles going around inside of the nucleus, as well as the nucleus being like a droplet that could be deformed. And on the train back, I realized that the particle going around inside could actually do the deforming. That same idea came to two of my American colleagues, James Rainwater and the son of Niels Bohr in New York, and they promptly checked it out and published a paper on it. And I was very pleased at that. But it just shows how ideas can get floating around. I wouldn't be at all surprised if the ideas that I had come to on the train had not come from Bohr, and that he had also conveyed the same idea to his son. Anyway, I left the family behind in Paris and went to New Mexico. I didn't feel we ought to break the children's school year. Poor Janette was left with the car, and when at the end of the school year she had to sell it, she found the French would not allow her to sell it because the title was in my name. So I had to get an official document made up in Los Alamos with the help of the Los Alamos lawyer, Ralph Carlisle Smith, and then it had to be sent to New Orleans to be stamped by the Consulate of France in New Orleans and then sent on to Janette in Paris so she could sell the car. And Ralph Carlisle Smith said, you ought to limit this transfer to just a car, because otherwise her bank account, her house, everything she could sell. As if I didn't trust her. He had been through a divorce, apparently, so that's how come he reacted that way. But anyway, I didn't change the document. The document gave her power to do any of these things.